Hey guys, it's Monika. I am going to share with you a couple of sun care tips. This actually came about in my previous video, or one of my previous videos, because I'm not too sure when this one's going to be published, where I had some questions on sunblock, how am I applying it, how's it working with my Retin A. So if you're interested in my sun care routine, stay tuned. Sun care, I think if you're going to be doing Retin A, if you're going to be using Retin A, sun care is so, so important. And I am really sort of a nudge about it. In other words, I really, really go all out when it comes to my sun care. I really do. So I am fortunate enough that I am sent some products for review, and then I'm also in a position where I can tell you which ones I like and which ones I haven't liked, and I can share with you the products that I have repeatedly, I have bought and used, and some of the things that I bought and for various reasons didn't use. So the question came up on my previous video, how do I apply the sunblock that I use the most? And it is the Australian Gold Botanical. Botanical, I know I'm saying it wrong, but this is the Australian Gold Mineral Lotion Non-Greasy Formula 50 SPF. This is the one I've been using the longest, and I use this the most, and I use it just about every day. So this is drying on me. I have a very dry skin, so when I put this on, this is really drying on me. When I use this, I'll have to use it after I do my morning routine, and I usually will put a face oil on in the morning, and lately that face oil has been a CBD oil, or I have marula oil and I have squalane. Those are the two oils that I use, so depending on what the condition of my skin will depend what oil I'm going to put on. When I put that oil on, I will usually at one point put my sunblock on, and then I would let it settle in and sit in really, really good. So this is what I've been doing and using the most of. It's affordable. I buy it on sale. I love it. I have a tube in the car. I have a tube in the office, so I can reapply throughout the day. I have it in my camper. I use this the most. It is the most affordable. So recently, however, I've been trying a couple of products. Dermatology, this was sent to me. This is a tinted moisturizer SPF 46. And the other one is a broad spectrum SPF 45. The 46 is a tinted moisturizer. I'm not too sure if you're going to be able to see it, but it really has a nice tint to it. It's a very attractive tint. It goes and blends in with my complexion really nicely. Oh, I just put it on top of my ring. Ugh. But it does. It blends in really nicely. I can put this all over my face. It's a light formula. It's not drying. I usually put it on my hands. I usually put it on the back of my neck. Then they also have the broad spectrum 45, which is, they call it anti-aging. I really like the ingredients, but this is a whiter look. But it also absorbs really well. So I have been trying those two products, and I will tell you that the moisturizer, the tinted moisturizer with the SPF 46, on a really active day where I'm going to be outside, I always use this. And so far, since I've had this, and this was absolutely sent to me, complimentary, I should say that as well, since I received this and since I've been using this, I actually like this a lot. It does not pill up with my makeup. It plays super, super nice with my makeup. So this for me is a real plus. On, like for example, this morning, I put this on after I did my skincare. I let it sink in. And then before I put my makeup on, because I was using a SPF makeup, I did not use this. But normally, if I'm using, say, my Estee Lauder or any of my other foundations that are 15, 20, 25, or 30 SPF, I put this on. So this usually goes on in the morning because I have it. But prior to that, I would be using this with a little bit of oil. Let it settle in. This is a 50 SPF. I always make sure I go down my neck. I go around my ears. I go in the back of my neck. And then I would put on whatever foundation that I'm using. I have also been trying, and I really like this as well, and I know that some of these prices can be higher, but it's going to be up to you. Skin Perfecting Daily Veil, this is a sunscreen, and I think this is a 38, but this is from City Beauty. I actually like this a lot. This is white, but it's not actually white. It's more of a, I think it's more of an off-white, a tinted. It covers really nice. I really like it. So far, the few times that I've used this, it has played nice with my makeup. Now, even though I use a, and this is what brought up the question, was the fact that I use number 7 Protect and Perfect Advanced All-in-One Foundation. I use this in the color Wheat. You can get this in Target. You can get this in Walgreens. You can get this pretty well anywhere. But this is the 50 SPF Protect and Perfect Advanced. This has the 50 SPF in it, as does my Shiseido that I use, which is a heck of a lot more pricey than this, as does the Buxom. Buxom has, I think, 30. I use this on an occasion, but it's a lot more pricey. The Boots, now, if you buy the Buxom, say, at the outlet, it isn't really. It comes out to be a pretty close price point. But the Boots number 7, Protect and Perfect, I like this. I bought this. Marlene sent me hers. It didn't work well with her. So I know that not everyone's skin is going to really enjoy this, so to speak. But that's what I've been doing. So if I'm going to go out, have a super active day, I know that I'm not going to put enough foundation on my face. I just don't. I like a full coverage, but I'm a light foundation user. I don't use enough, in my opinion, that this would ever protect me fully for sun. So they kind of go hand in hand, for sure. Or the, I cannot tell you how much I really am enjoying the tinted moisturizer. I really like that. But then again, I'm also enjoying the Daily Veil from City Beauty. So, but anyways, whatever foundation I have that has an SPF in, typically I would never get enough coverage without putting sunblock on first. And that's the dilemma. Because on my skin, not every sunblock works the same. It does not. And you want a full broad spectrum. You want the anti-aging rays as well as the anti-burning rays. The anti-aging rays, those are the ones you don't even know happen. Those are the ones that go deep in your skin and damage because you're not burning, so you think you're okay and you can stay out longer. I don't want that to happen. I use Retin A. My skin is way more, I think, susceptible to burns because of Retin A. So I am just going to be super, super careful. And I know intellectually that no matter what foundation I am using that has any kind of an SPF in it, I'm not going to put enough of it on to cover and protect the way I need to. So I always couple, and I love the fact that this has got a 50 SPF, and I love the fact that this is not drying on my skin. So this has become my summertime foundation of choice. It just gives me that way more protection, and I love that this plays nice with it. So these are the two that I would say I've used the most. And but this tinted moisturizer SPF also plays well with this combo, as does the City Beauty. Plays really nice with this combo. So whichever one I put on first on a normal day in the summer, especially when I'm going outside walking, then I would put, this has been my foundation of choice. So during the day, I also can touch up. I have a couple of compacts that I got. These were sent to me last year. They're just compacts that have sunblock in. You can touch up that way. I also will touch up using my Color Science. This is the one with the little brush. You've seen this before. More often than not, this lives in my car, and I use this on my hands. I put this on my hands in my car. Sometimes I'll do it on my face, but more often than not, on my face, I am going to be using one of my compacts because I can't let it dry out. I also love the Color Science Total Eye. This has got a 30 SPF. It's sort of like a little bit of a highlighter or a concealer. I use very little products under my eyes, very little. And I know I should use more because I have the dark marks, I have the veins, and my under eyes are not pretty. But usually I'll use this more in the corners for the sunblock if I know that I haven't gone all the way up on my eyes with the sunblock. I'll use this as sort of more of a touch-up. I really like this. The color, it does blend, but it comes on much darker, more pinker toned for me. But I can blend it in, but I like the fact that I'm getting that protection. And then the other thing is I wear sunglasses every single day of the week. I do. I wear sunglasses. And I probably have no exaggeration, maybe 10, 15 pairs of sunglasses. This particular pair was sent to me in one of my Balzano subscription handbag bags. They always have little things in the bags, and this was sent to me along with one other time I got another pair that I wear a lot that you guys compliment me on. So I always wear sunglasses because I think they are probably one of the best anti-aging devices you can get out there, especially if you wear really good sunglasses, dark sunglasses, because wearing them will prevent you from squinting into the sun. And then, of course, there's hats. So I wear ball caps a lot. You know, when I'm out and about, especially when I'm camping, I wear ball caps a lot. And I recently bought these two visors. This is a visor with the pink bow. I showed this in one of my other videos. And then this one with the, this is a 50 SPF broad spectrum hat. And it really, I mean, it really, I know it looks silly right now, but it really does a great job. I also have the driving gloves. I think Mary Glitzy Fritzy, I think I got these off of, when she talked about them quite a while ago, and she had them linked. I believe I bought them off of her Amazon link originally. They live in my car along with this. But I'll use the color science and I brush that over my hands. I very rarely, look at they look brand new. I probably have only worn these a couple of times. The concept is really good. I'm just not disciplined enough. And half the time, if it's warm out, if they're harder to get on, I'm not disciplined enough. But I have them and I think they're a great idea because, you know, my age shows my hands age me. They show my age very much, just like my neck. So I try to be really good with my driving gloves, but I'm not. I hope you guys are better at them if you have them. Ball caps, you know, all the time, like I said, and then making sure lately all my straw hats, I've wanted to make sure that they have the SPF, the 50 factor in there so that, you know, I can feel totally comfortable that the top of my head, my forehead is protected as much as possible. I also wanted to say really quickly that I had gotten some masks. Now, I know that some of you will not believe in masks and some of you do, and that's a personal choice that you make. I'm not here to tell anyone to do anything, but Carol from the O'Carroll Show, her son makes these masks. And so I get, because I'm an essential worker, I get the ones from the state. So I figured I don't really need these masks. But yes, we, in our state, many places you can't go into, most of our supermarkets or anything like that without a mask on. So about maybe 3 weeks ago, I ordered these from Carol. And you would think a mask is a mask, right? A mask is a mask. No, a mask is not a mask. These are actually super comfortable, as well as I'm going to probably order more because there was some colors that she was out of that I really wanted to get. But I actually bought three. She sent me a fourth one. The black one that she sent, I wear all the time because it matches with everything. But I love these masks. So just on the line of protection, you know, a face mask, if you are looking for an affordable, stylish, different colors, check out Carol from the O'Carroll Show. I will be sure to link her channel below. So that's sort of my combination. I hope this isn't too long. I'll see what I cut out. But that's sort of my what I do for my sunblock. I also want to just mention quickly, I talked about this super sponge. This is kind of dirty because I just used it this morning. I talked about this super sponge. When you use this edge, the foundation that you put on does not sink into the sponge. You have to be super careful how much you put on to use because If you use a normal sponge or your fingers, you use way more product than you would when you use this, because the product doesn't soak into the sponge. So I've actually been using this not just to apply my foundation, but also to apply my sunscreen, so that I know that I'm not swishing the sunscreen around and removing it when I use this super sponge. So who knew? Who knew? Yes, this was sent to me complimentary for review, but I'm telling you guys, I really like these sponges, and I think overall, and I'm not a sponge person, but overall, this can save a lot of money in product use, in my opinion. You just have to get used to not squirting out as much as you might normally think you need, because you're not going to need it. So anyways, that's all about sunscreen. Hopefully this is helpful. Just remember, whatever you use, use it consistently every single day. And, you know, whether I have a day that it's an outdoor day or a day that it's an indoor day will vary on the amount of sunscreen. But I use sunscreen every single day, 7 days a week. And I use it every day of the year. I do. Even if I'm home, I will put a, if I'm not wearing any makeup or whatever, I will put a light dose of sunscreen on because I'm walking near the windows and whatnot. So anyways, guys, I hope this is helpful, and thank you so much for watching. I will chat with you later. Bye, guys.